Hi, Peter from Callouts here. Today I wanted to do a quick tutorial on how you can do transitions, both seamless and overlay transitions. I will explain what I mean with that in just a moment. I also wanted to let you know that we have 30 free transitions on Callouts that you can download without a membership, and lots of more transitions for our members. Let's dive in and check it out. Okay, so here we are in Camtasia, and first let me show you what I mean with an overlay and a seamless transition. So I have a video layer here, or rather a picture illustrating a video A and a video B. So without a transition, we all know what it will be, a straight cut like this between them. And an overlay transition would be a transition that you place on top of these two to hide the cut between them. And this is this one that I quickly made here with some dots going in, and there the cut is covered, and there you have the second video. And here is the same transition that I used, a little bit modified, to create what I call a seamless transition. And with that, I mean a transition where you don't put it as an overlay like we did in this example, but where actually video A goes into video B, or video B goes into video A. So in this case, we have video A, and the spots that we had before is appearing from A to B instead. So that's what I mean. So I wanted to quickly show you how you can make a video like this, or a transition like this, rather. And let's do something similar than what I did in the first example. So I will just grab here you can grab whatever graphics you have, but I will grab the standard annotations here from TextMate, and let's use the yellow dots here. And I'm just gonna have a number of dots, and I hold down shift because I want it to be a straight circle and not another shape. So I hold down shift when I resize it. So I will have some big ones, and I will have some smaller ones, and I just copy and paste the same on top of each other here and change the size of the new one. So there we have like four different sizes. Now I'm going to copy all of these a couple of times and just drag them out to cover the whole screen here. The bigger they are, the less work you need to do, but there. We're going to fill the rest with a small one, see if we can find. We'll copy that one and paste and make it a little bit smaller. Now I'm just copying out that one, and I'm filling all the spaces. And maybe in some cases you can use the ones that you have to just fill it out. I'm just going to change the sizes on some of them here to cover the little spots there. Became a lot of them here. There we have the whole thing. So, oh, there. Now I think it covers everything. So there we have our transition. I'm gonna mark all of these And I'm gonna, to make it easy for myself, you could individually, of course, animate each one. You could also put them a little bit in different timings, that they start differently, like. But to make this video a little bit quicker, we're just gonna leave them at the same time space. See if we can mark them all here. There we do it. And I will use the behaviors to animate them quickly and easily. And so let's do a pulsating on them, for example. See how that becomes. So I think we will skip the during and set the during here on the right hand side. I have the properties for them, and because I marked all of them now, I have 29 different layers. I can change the behavior for all 29 at the same time. So during, I will set that to none, so we know that we have a static point in the transition where actually the whole entire screen is covered, so you can have your cut between your two clips under in that point. And then the in, grow, spring, and out, ease out, back, and we'll lower the speed to make it a little bit visible, and we'll set the growing in also to an ease in instead of a spring. Ease in, back, and we'll lower that speed also to 50 something. Now let's take a look. There they grow. And I think this becomes a little long, so we're going to make the whole thing shorter. Let's go for 3 seconds. Something like that. Now let's see how quick it is. There, we have a transition. So this is now, could be, I mean, it could be ready now. It's an overlay transition. You cover the two layers underneath and you can use it like that. But we want to stylize it a little bit more, so we're going to group these layers. And then we're actually going to change them to be rings instead. I have to mark them all. So we go into the group here. And we say all. And we say fill 0 and the outline. We're going to put the color to the same. So. And we need a thickness, so let's say 4, something like that. And that's not the transition, because now you're going to see through here the cut. But I am going to copy this one, this whole group. And just after that one starts, we're going to put another group. And that group is going to be filled in. I could of course have done this before. I didn't have to change it and then change it back, but never mind. We take the opacity to 100% and we take the thickness down to 0 of the outline. There. Let's see what became of this. I'll play it a little bit slow. course, the rings are inside, moving out. So what we could do is we could extend this one a little bit. Okay, maybe too much. Something like, see if we, something like that. Okay, so there we have a transition. Now I'm grouping it together. And you could set the colors of the transition here and the outlines there. And so you could save this one to your library. Add to library ring transition or transition rings. Well, we will put it in the test folder in the meantime. Okay, so if I had this one and I had a video A and a video B, and the video, we want to cover the cut, but we got to figure out where is the screen entirely blocked with the transition. So I step it one by one here, and there, from that point, we could call that our in point in the transition. And then I step one by one here to see where parts of it becomes transparent again. And somewhere there is the last point where we could place the transition. And we will call that one out. So there we have our in and out points. So we'll have to put the transition between these points when it's all covered. So we have red and we have the transition, and switching over to video B. Now we wanted to change the color to a green color instead. We would just go into the transition. We would pick some aqua there, and the same for the ellipses, perhaps like that, and see how it looks. Transition. So that's how you do an overlay transition, a transition that covers your cut entirely. Now let's use this same transition, but make it a seamless transition where we use it to get one layer going into the other layer. So to do that, the two layers have to go above each other. And since we have an in point and an out point here, we can't use both of them. We gotta either go in or go out. So what I will do is I will cut the transition at the out point here completely and delete that part because we're not gonna need that part. And we're gonna place the two video layers underneath. Now it doesn't work. But what we have to do is we have to set up a matte layer of this transition instead. This means that this one, the transition layer, is going to obscure video one, so video B is revealed. Video A, so video A is removed and video B is revealed. So we're going to place them on top of each other. So we're revealing video B from video A. And so I will use the visual effect. And we have it up here. Where is it? There, media matte. So I drop it on there. So it, because we chose the in part of this transition, we need to set it as an alpha invert layer because it's going to reveal the video behind. And now it should work directly. As you see, the video B is popping in and video A is disappearing. And there We have made a seamless transition from scratch. So then you can just save this, and now the endpoint will not work here. When you're working with a seamless transition, you have to have them covering the entirety of the out and in point. So seamless transition. So there you have it. Let's try this transition on a video to see instead of the test layers there. Let me open a video. Let's drag in some time lapses from callouts here. So here I have two videos, and that's a straight cut there. And we can test it with the, let me go to library and call it transition rings, the first one, right? And I didn't get the in and out point there with me, but I think it was somewhere there. Like that. So with the overlay transition, it would look like this. And with the seamless transition, put it there, and the revealing layer underneath there, it would be like this. Let me drag it a little bit slower so you see. So there you have it. It was a little quick tutorial on how to make your own transitions. I hope you liked it, and please do subscribe to our channel to check out other tutorials and assets for video and for Camtasia. And see you soon. And don't forget to download our free transitions from callouts as well. Thank you. See you soon. Bye.